Praise God. Praise God. Let the people of God say amen. Amen. I welcome you to the Bread Broadcast, a Bible teaching program where we edify, we exalt, and challenge believers to the Great Commission. Here, we also call sinners to salvation through the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining us. Today, having finished a three-part series on the three enemies that we have, I believe the Holy Spirit wants us to be blessed, to know our spiritual blessings. So the topic today is spiritual blessings in summary. Spiritual blessings in summary. Our case study is Simon Peter, my big brother. Y'all know I love him. And a short reading is John, the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 21, verse 15, we stop at 19. John 21, 15 to 19. Let us pray. Father, through our Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, we thank you. We praise you. Because through it all, you have remained faithful. You have been so good. There is none like you. And you are good all the time. So we want to say thank you. Thank you for bringing us together again. Oh Lord, we ask that you bless every listening here through this program. And Father, every receptive heart, oh Lord, let us go away from this teaching with double blessings. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Our foundation text is the book of Isaiah, chapter 32, verse 2. Isaiah 32, verse 2. A man will be as a hiding place from the wind, and a cover from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a weary land. And aren't we traveling through a weary land as believers, pilgrims on our way to heaven? The world is a weary land. The text that we just read in Isaiah is the summary of our spiritual blessings that we have as believers and disciples of Christ Jesus. These are the spiritual blessings that every believer in Christ Jesus can expect from the man, Christ Jesus. What are these spiritual blessings? Jesus becomes this to you, or does this to you, if you are a genuine believer. Number one, he becomes a refuge. The Lord Jesus becomes an immediate, underscore that please, an immediate refuge from the storm of Adam's curse. The moment you give your life to our Lord Jesus Christ, it becomes your immediate refuge from Adam's curse. A safe place to shelter so you are no longer scattered. Before Peter, Simon Peter, a case study, before he met the Lord, he could only boast of fishing to feed his family. He had no clue that he was destined to do great things for God, that his name would be written in the Bible, and for centuries, his name would be mentioned all over the world, in all tribes, countries, and nations, you see. Peter's life began to take shape when he obeyed the Lord and forsook everything he had or he had known to become a disciple of Christ Jesus. the first immediate blessing. Listen up, please. Experienced by an individual who surrenders to the Lord is the protection from living a life that has no direction or living below divine standards, you see. Until you come to the knowledge of Christ Jesus, until you get right with Christ Jesus, you would not know what you have been born to do. Even if you are enjoying what you are doing, I promise you, without Christ Jesus, you are definitely living below divine standards for your life, you see. When Christ becomes our Lord, not just our Savior, but our Lord, meaning he tells us what we need to do and we obey. His word becomes our guiding light and his Holy Spirit becomes our compass. As a result, our decisions in life will be informed by God's word and we are able to live with wisdom. I remember a lady that I discipled for about 7 years in Sydney, Australia. And she had really major mental issues going on. And she had a psychotherapist and a psychologist that she would go to. And she came back one day and said, Sister Josephine, maybe I should stop going to this psychotherapist because everything you tell me, he also tells me. He's like repeating everything you are telling me. And each time he says something, I would say, oh, Sister Josephine told me that. And he said, maybe you ought to be listening to Josephine. She seems to be a wise lady. And I said, no, I'm not wise. I am not wise. Forget it. I'm a goofball. But I just repeat what the Bible says, you see. When you tell me this is what is going on, I repeat what the Word of God says. That's why, you know, the Word of God makes me look good, you see. When we live by the Word of God and the Holy Spirit begins to guide us, then we look wise to people that are watching us. The result of that over the course of time is a life well ordered. As we become who God has called us to be, and a life put together as we do what God has called us to do, you see. We can categorize this area of the human life as the natural physical life where we interact with the physical material world. Let's go to Matthew chapter 11, a very popular verse. Verse 28, we stop at 29. The Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 11, 28, we stop at 29. Come unto me, this is Jesus speaking now, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. Blessing. To believe in Christ is to receive eternal rest. To obey Christ is to find rest in life. I am going to back up because we are talking two kinds of rests there. So I will say it slowly. You see, there's a rest that only our Lord Jesus Christ can give you as a gift. And it's forever. Okay? Now, there is a rest you find through obedience to his directives. To believe in Christ is to receive eternal rest. That's the gift of salvation that can't be taken away. Now, to obey Christ is to find rest in life. So, if you're a believer and your life is full of worries, you are stressed, just like everybody around you, is because your obedience is not yet fully complete. in one or more areas of your life, but you can find that rest in Jesus' name. The second spiritual blessing we receive, and please, I want you to know the Holy Spirit asked me to stress this, that all the promises in the Word of God for God's children is first and foremost spiritual. Please, the promises of provision, of prosperity, of protection is first and foremost spiritual. Okay? Then it translates into the physical. So that's why we get disappointed in God every now and then. I don't know about you, but I'm learning. I'm getting better. Praise God. But we kind of get disappointed, like, oh God, I asked that you provide for me, and it didn't happen. No, it's because we are looking at the physical first. But God has already provided in the spiritual, and we are still going, oh God, oh God. So please remember that from today, that all the promises of God will be met in our lives first in our spiritual lives. The second thing that the Lord Jesus does to you as his child, once you give your life to him, is he refreshes. Life in Christ Jesus refreshes the mind. Oh, hallelujah. No longer is the mind under the weight of the guilt of sin. At resurrection, the angel of God sent message to Christ's disciples and mentioned Peter by name. This was to assure Peter that the Lord had nothing against Peter having repented. Peter's reaction, as detailed in the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verse 1 to 10, please go read it. It was the reaction of a soul who was no longer under the oppression of his past or the things happening around him. Peter became quickened in his spirit, and his reaction was a lively one to go and see the empty tomb of Christ. The power of Jesus frees the mind of his followers from the load of past guilt. Listen, let me tell you one thing. If not for the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, the shed blood of the cross of Christ Jesus that has cleansed me, I can't even live a day with myself, seriously, with the guilt of my past life. But praise God for the blood of the cross. When he cleansed me, listen, I'm clean, I'm free, you see. And that's one of our spiritual blessings. We are freed from the guilt of our past, and we are also not affected by circumstances around us because we have divine perspectives on things. A disciple of Jesus is able to keep his or her head while others who do not believe in Christ are losing theirs. You see, this does not mean we do not get touched by adversities, sorrows, or pains. I told you, I shared with you about 3 lessons ago how my immediate older brother, 48 years old, I was suddenly called that he's gone to heaven. You see, that's painful. I'm still mourning, but I'm not mourning like somebody with no hope, you see. That is the power of the blood of the cross. We still get touched with sorrows and pains, but even in our crying and sadness, we can still sing the song of hope. Hallelujah. We can categorize this area of the human life as the soul. You see, when we talk about the blessing of Christ refreshing our mind, this is the soul area where we interact with the psychological world, where we battle all kinds of emotional and mental storms. You see, if not for Christ, I know a lot of people, including myself, we would have gone to the mental house. Seriously, we would have lost our minds. But praise God. I mean, I can begin to give you examples of sisters that a particular sister, she was going through chemotherapy. In the midst of that, a husband of 30-something years filed for a divorce for no reason. If not for Jesus, and she will still show up in my office smiling. Where do you think somebody like that would have received the strength and not going to pieces mentally, if not Jesus refreshing our mind? You see, that's one of our spiritual blessings. Romans chapter 8, verse 33, we stop at 34. And I'm going to read the contemporary English version. Romans 8, 33, 34. If God says, listen up. If God says his chosen ones are acceptable to him, can anyone bring charges against them? Listen up, please. Or can anyone condemn them? I don't think so. No, indeed. Christ died, hallelujah, and was raised to life, hallelujah. And now he is at God's right side, speaking to him for us, hallelujah. In plain English, what that Bible verse is saying is, if God says you are good enough, who is going to say you are not? If God says I've forgiven Josephine Zion, she's perfect in my eyes through my son, Lord Jesus, who is going to say, oh no, God don't forgive her? That is what that Bible verse is saying. You see, that is why we are refreshed in our mind as believers, because the Lord says, you are forgiven, you've never sinned in your life, because I'm looking at you through my son, Jesus. Who is going to say, oh, she's saying, God, I don't forgive her. Excuse me? God said, I forgive her. You can say you don't? No. Praise God. To find your mind in Christ is to free your mind in life. Let's say that again. It's so beautiful. Together, let's go now. To find your mind in Christ is to free your mind in life. Praise God. Praise God. The third blessing that we receive, and now each of these blessings, they have tentacles that goes into all kinds of areas of our lives. But remember, we said in summary, you see, in summary. So the third blessing that we receive when we come to the Lord and become his child or his children is he revives us. The third spiritual blessing which an individual gains by surrendering their life to the Lord Jesus is Christ himself becomes the rock which provides a massive shadow, according to that foundation text, you see, as we travel through the desert wasteland called the earth. Deserts are usually hot and dry. Have you noticed it's the same thing about life? You are happy in the morning, and by evening time, you are looking for an exit, if possible, because everything is just coming at you, you see. When Simon Peter would later face persecutions, and he faced quite a lot of them, and leadership challenges with the early church at Jerusalem, at such times, he often reverted back to the events in Christ's ministry in which he had the opportunity to be a witness. When the Sanhedrin, when they said, shut your mouth, don't preach this Jesus in Jerusalem again, he said, we can't help but preach what we have seen with our eyes and heard with our ears, you see. Thus, Simon Peter found courage to confidently express his faith to others and to share the hope of eternity in Christ Jesus. Listen up, please. Our spiritual blessing rises above the earth because through the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, listen up closely, please. Through the indwelling of the Holy Spirit in our hearts, our spirit is connected to heaven. Are you getting this? The Holy Spirit is the connector between your spirit as a child of God and the throne room. Thus, we are revived in times of earthly weariness when our spirit is reminded by the Holy Spirit of the glory that is ahead of us in heaven. I remember praying yesterday at a point. I said, Father, I need strength. I'm kind of weary. I said, help me, Lord. And I just began to ask God, and I began to pray, and I began to seek the face of the Lord. And the Lord helped. He revived my spirit. And here I am again today, you see. Even though I'm going through such a difficult time. But here I am, not in my own strength, but I've received help. I've received the spiritual blessing of revival by the Holy Spirit. This is how we are able to interact with the celestial spiritual world in a troubled physical world, you see. That is how our spirit is able to tune out and connect to heaven, because the Holy Spirit revives us. Job 19:25, this is one of my favorites in the Bible. Job 19:25, thank God for that old patriarch. He said, for I know that my Redeemer liveth, hallelujah, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. That is, Jesus is coming back, in English. That's what he's saying. And though after my skin once destroyed this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God. Hallelujah. He said, even though my body could have laid in the dust before Jesus appears in the sky and the worms have eaten up my skin, but the real person on the inside will still see Jesus when he appears. Amen. When our spirit is tied to the Lord, we will rise above the storm. When our spirit is tied to the Lord, we will rise above the storm. If your spirit is tied to the money you're making, you're going to crash and burn. I'm promising you. You know why? Because a day is coming, your money is going to be useless for you. If your spirit is tied to your house and whatever you have, if it's not the Lord, you are going to be disappointed bitterly. But if your spirit is tied to the Lord Jesus Christ, you have nothing to worry about, because he always takes his own above the storm. Amen. So what have we done so far? What are spiritual blessings? In summary, Christ becomes our refuge. Our natural physical life begins to take shape by following God and his word. Christ refreshes. Our mind receives clarity. We are no longer burdened with guilt. Christ revives. Our spirit cannot be defeated because we are tuned to heaven, where Christ is. Now, as a believer, a genuine disciple and follower of Jesus who obeys his word, are you enjoying all these spiritual blessings as you ought? Huh? Because I ask myself. If you're not, it is because you are failing to put your trust in God to take care of you in every area of life. I remember I used to worry about money. Oh my goodness, have mercy, oh Lord. I used to worry about money a lot. Until God brought me to a point and the Holy Spirit said, you entrusted your future, your eternity into the hand of the Lord Jesus. What is money? And that was the day I received my deliverance. One thing I know is I will not go beyond what I'm supposed to spend. I will not put myself in debt. So if I'm within my spiritual bounds, I know God will fulfill his promise to provide for me. And he has never failed, you see. So if you are not enjoying the full blessings of God in every area of your life as a believer, check your obedience mirror. It's not complete. As you trusted Christ with your eternity, so hand over every area of your life to him and leave the consequences to him. You will begin to experience the divine spiritual blessings which God has provided for his children through our Lord Jesus Christ. Are you an unbeliever? Or you just go to church, but you know in your heart that the Lord Jesus is not in your heart, the Holy Spirit is not there, then you are not a child of God. You are not a Christian. But that can change. If you are an unbeliever, the Bible says you are living under the curse, according to Deuteronomy and the book of Genesis. The curse of Adam, your ancestor. See, Jesus is my ancestor because I switched over. But if you are yet to give your life to the Lord, Adam is still your progenitor, you see. And so every unbeliever is under the curse of Adam and the curse of breaking the Ten Commandments because you have refused to trust in Christ Jesus. If you believe in doing good things, I don't do bad stuff, I do good things to people, then you are under the curse of the Ten Commandments. And if you break one, you have broken everything. Jesus only prayed for those who would believe in him. A life without Jesus has no natural direction, has no lasting joy, and can be easily defeated by life's circumstances. Such a life ends up in an eternal lake of fire. Listen, it's not a winner, whichever way you look at it. Whoever lives outside of Christ Jesus, they are losers in every area of life. Listen, including eternity. They end up in eternal lake of fire in a conscious state of everlasting punishment. However, Jesus died to change that for you. You, especially you, yes. You don't have to go through all that. Oh no. If you are ready to come out from under the curse, a link is coming up. Follow that link and we will meet you there and lead you to how you can surrender your life to Christ Jesus. So the curse can now be changed in your life to blessings, spiritual blessings that we have talked about. Father, thank you. Oh, sweet Lord Jesus, we praise you. Thank you, dear sweet blessed Holy Spirit, that the plan of salvation originated from the heart of the Father because he loved the world so. And God the Son carried it out because he loved us so. And God the Holy Spirit drew us to Christ because he loved us so. And Father, we pray that for every believer who are still struggling in one area of their life, Father, that you help us to totally surrender everything to you so we can have total access to the spiritual blessings that you have provided for us in Christ Jesus. And for those going to want to know Jesus page, Father, we pray that you meet with them. Open their eyes and let the word be implanted into their heart. Let them understand, O Lord. In Jesus' name, I will pray. Amen and amen. I will see you next week, only if Jesus has not split the sky open.